Fucking Porsche, I don't want it if that ass don't sit like a horse. I be ballin' on these niggas, got me feeling like.
What's up, gamers? It's your boy Fat Dollars bringing you some more of that fire Madden tips to help you elevate your game. And if this is the first time you ever checked out a video, make sure you drop a like on the video. It's free for you to do. Make sure you become a subscriber and then hit the notification bell. Also, I'm gonna start rewarding the first couple people that come to the video. You will be entered into giveaways, so make sure you keep that in the back of your head. Today we're gonna go over two adjustments to be able to help you just on the defensive side, so you can limit all the flukes. We're gonna be in the nickel 335i, which is in the Patriots defensive playbook. I'm not sure if they even got this in another playbook. I know the Ravens got the 335 regular, but on this you can play the Tampa 2 or you can do the crossfire, and I'm gonna show you both of them in the video. Now I'm gonna show you the key personnels. I'm not gonna show you just how to set up a certain kind of blitz. I'm gonna show you the key to being able to limit things. And you also need to watch the lines, because the clouds and different coverages play different on the right hash mark and on the left hash mark. So keep that in the back of your head. That is probably the only thing that you don't know as far as when to call certain defensive coverages. Now, your linebacker you always want on the hash mark. You can see on the screen right now, my middle linebacker that I'm dropping in deep blue is on top of the hash mark, or you can have him barely to the inside of it. That right there will put him at a better run fit. If you know how to check your run fits, you will realize that is crucial to this defense. And also spreading your safeties, because as soon as they hike the ball, watch the safeties. They drop back and then they slowly go to the outsides. So that's the reason why you want to manually move them out. I would say 3 to 4 steps as much as possible in case he's quick hiking or anything like that. So you're going to see it's 3rd and 6. I am up 14-0. And the block sheds get there because how I got my defensive run fit set up. That means that the one-on-ones happen better on the defensive line. All I want to do is base a line, spread my defensive line, and crash out. And then you got a blitzing angle on the crossfire. Now this is not something that you want to run against a double C route or a corner strikes or something like that. You want to mix it up with the Tampa 2. That's going to make him uncomfortable, knowing that he can't throw it to the sidelines. And then that's when you want to sneak the crossfire linebacker crossfire 3 in. Like I said, you want to base a line, you want to spread your D line and crash out, and you want to use it the other side. Now you can play around with that. You can man up a cornerback over there. You can take that that yellow that's dropping down, which is one of the safeties. You can man him up if you want to. It's a little tricky, but it's a lot of different things you can do in every coverage, because you're able to make quick adjustments to get everything set up. And then if he's making adjustments, you got more time to make changes. You can see me going from the crossfire to the Tampa 2. Now in my Tampa 2 defense, I like to have auto flip on. Every time I'm in the 335i, I like to have auto flip on. That's real key in case you want to get real glitchy and send the cornerback. As you can see, we coming in there filling up the gap, because the run fits, like I told you earlier in the video, is crucial. Base a line, spread D line, crash out. Now on the Tampa 2, all you want to do is stop the passes. So if you think that he gonna run to the left, you want your linebacker to be user on the right, and etc. It's all love. Let's go.
Side and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Bree's gonna try and throw on third down. And he will bring it back. An interception return.
Because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
On the handoff, Tomlinson. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall at the 46. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd and 11. Now they'll throw with Breeze. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down.
Put him on the ground. He's going to end up with a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
There's Breeze. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. It's the linebacker, Michael Kendrick.